I'm Dr. Susann Stritzke. I'm a research associate for renewable energy at the Smith School of Enterprise and the Environment here at the University of Oxford. I'm currently working on a project that is called Mumuni Singani, which is Tonga and stands for Light in Singani. Behind that project is the big question of how can we sustainably electrify Africa and other regions in the world and give people the chance to have access to clean energy and light, which they currently don't.
My name is Dr. Hindolo George Williams, and I'm a postdoctoral researcher in energy systems. I'm working on a project seeking to improve Sierra Leone's energy sector. In the capital, Freetown, there are on average about 53 blackouts a day. So if we do not solve the issues affecting Sierra Leone's energy sector now, this is going to hold the people back. Well, it's going to hold the country back, economic activities, healthcare, education. To start with, what we want to really do with this project is bring a paradigm change. What I mean by this is change the way the utilities handle their technical operations, handle their financial operations, the general organizational structure, the way things work, basically, the way projects, for example, are implemented.
I was part of a corporate social responsibility program. I went to Zambia. 98% of the people in villages do not have access to clean energy or to any form of reliable energy. So they are not connected to the electrical grid, which means that limits them in all kind of their daily life. I want to develop solar energy solutions that are sustainable, live longer than 5 years, and improve people's life and develop the whole community.
I have basically experienced these issues, the issues about not having a reliable electricity supply, okay, firsthand. I cooked with firewood, I cooked with charcoal, I studied on candle, basically, and even oil lamp, okay? So it's sort of close to my heart, okay? I have acquired this knowledge, I've studied in good universities, so I think this is really my opportunity to give back to my country, basically.
These are all the complex questions, and then these communities are affected by climate change. They are rural farmers. If there's no rain, they have no income. That happens a lot. So we need to solve these issues, and the more we look into that, the more solutions we have to find.
So we are working with the utility to create a software that will help reduce the number of blackouts and help them fix them quickly as well.
We have great technical solutions, great battery solutions, but that's not necessarily an issue. It is one component, but it's only one component. So we need to now shift and look into the community. So what are the conditions that prevent energy projects from taking off, and how can we change them? And then create a sustainable development in the communities to create a better life and break that glass ceiling that currently restrains these communities from leapfrogging into the 21st century.
But in the long term, I really want to go back home and contribute to the reforming of the energy sector and also contribute to building sustainable energy systems.
And the next step, we have reached stage two for a tender process. And if we're lucky, we can build it and we can implement it at 5 pilot sites in Zambia within the next 2 to 3 years. That's a very important step to demonstrate it is doable, it is possible. And then the time will show whether, I hope it will be, whether this concept will be sustainable. And this is the key to solutions.